grew up in really the typical Texas suburb. My mom was like the picture of a housewife. She would drive us all to school in the morning, like pack us lunches, bake us casserole. When you think of like a mom, like that's my mom. But she definitely wasn't always like that. Back in the 80s, my mom was like a total badass.
Back in high school, my friends and I definitely marched to a different beat than most of our peers.
She was like really into like the whole punk scene. She looked like she could kick my butt. And she was a lot cooler than I thought. But she didn't tell me any of this until I started getting into music.
When our children were young, we got them MP3 players and just filled them with all kinds of music.
Dead Kennedys.
Elvis.
Sex Pistols.
Conway Twitty.
The Clash.
Just everything you can think of.
When I started playing live shows and stuff, I started picking and choosing clothes from her wardrobe to wear on stage.
I had a leather trench coat that he liked a lot.
It fit well, and it looked super cool. I looked like a vampire hunter.
He tried to wear my leather pants. He didn't have the heinie for them. So the leather pants were actually a fail, but he did try.
Eleanor Rigby picks up the rice in a church where a wedding has been. Lives in a dream, awaits at the wind, wearing a face that she keeps in a jar by the door. But who is it for, all the lonely people? Where do they all come from? All the lonely people, where do they all belong? Father Mackenzie, writing the words of a sermon that no one will hear. No one comes near, look at him working, donning his socks in the night when there's nobody there. But what does he care, all the lonely people? Where do they all come from? All the lonely people, where do they all belong? Church and was buried along with her name, and nobody came. Father Mackenzie wiping the dirt from his hands as he walks from the grave. No one was saying, all lonely people, where do they all come from? All the lonely people, where do they all?
Something about that, yeah. First time.
It was a great, great song choice. It was a great key for you. You pushed it about as high as you could, and
yes.
It was, you know, it was, if it had been a half a step higher, it would have been too high. Half step lower would have been too low. I was dying to hear what you were going to do with that song. And an arrangement like that with a performance like that, that's introducing, it's hard to believe no one would know that song, but I would imagine that there's people in younger generations who don't know it. And you did a great job introducing that song to them.
Thank you.
That means really good.
Thank you.
Yeah, it's cool. You guys know all the cool songs, because I saw you sing a Stand By Me and everything, so it's very cool. That was such a great song for you. You know what I love about you? You bring out the cinematic part of you, the theatrical part of you brings out undercurrents in a song that I've never really noticed before. There's a dark undercurrent in that song that you brought out really, really well. And like a good waffle iron, you made an impression.
Because it was so you. It's exactly what we want from you. You do bring us theatrical performances, but there's lots of great pop stars who have that theatricality to them. And I just wanted to say, I loved at the end, because you've been shying away a little bit from having these big endings. You know what I mean? And you've been doing, like, just talk the last word, blah. And it's been working.